Welcome to our channel. So in today's session, let us have a look on one of the concepts of information security, that is IP security. This is an internet protocol security. So in order to implement these IP security, we have to implement two protocols. One is ESP protocol and AH protocol. Now first let us have a look on what are the services of this IP security, and then we will see the architecture of this IP security. Now services. So as we have discussed in the previous sessions, in the earlier sessions, the services, security services are confidentiality, authentication, integrity and signature. So similarly, this IP security also provides these services, that is confidentiality, authentication, similarly integrity. So what type of authentication we can call it as, right? So these are the services provided by the IP security. Now let us see the architecture, IP security architecture. So in order to secure the traffic or data, we need to implement the two protocols, ESP and AH protocols. So IP security architecture. IP security, right? So two protocols are implemented, ESP protocol AH protocol. So ESP means encapsulation security payload, encapsulating security payload. So here the ESP protocol consists of all the encryption algorithms. Similarly, AH protocol consists of authentication algorithms. So this ESP protocol provides the confidentiality service, and AH protocol provides the authentication along with the integrity. So in order to support both the encryption as well as authentication, we'll use this DOI, domain of interpretation. So domain of interpretation means the identifiers which supports both the authentication algorithms and the cryptographic algorithms, I mean encryption algorithms. And finally, there is a key management. So as we have discussed earlier, the key management is how the key is exchanged between the sender and receiver. So if it is a public key encryption, I mean if it is a asymmetric encryption, how to distribute the public keys, and if it is a symmetric encryption, how to distribute or how to send the secret key from sender to receiver. So that is the key management. This is completely the IP security architecture. Two protocols, ESP and AH. So let us have a look on ESP protocol and then AH protocol. So before going to the topic, either AH protocol or ESP protocol, the main important thing is the security association, the concept of security association. So we can call it as SA. This is a security association. So security association is the communication between the client and server. So this security association is a one-way communication of client and server. So if client, or we can say any system, here server, here one more system, right? If client wants to communicate with, yes, the client should have security association of client. So with the help of security association of client, the client will send the messages to server. And if server wants to give a response to the client, server should have a security association. So with the help of security association of server, the server will communicate with the client. So this security association is a temporary message or a communication link between the client and server. So it's a one-way communication. So this security association is meant for only the one-way communication. So if both the parties want to communicate, two security associations should be established. So what are the parameters for identifying the security association? So security association parameters. So in order to identify the security association, we are having three parameters. First one is security parameter index. We can call it as SPI. So this will be carried out in both the protocols, AH protocol or ESP protocol. In both the protocols, this security parameter index will be there. So this is just like our unique number given to that particular security association. Next, IP destination address. IP destination address. So here, this IP destination address means, as we said that it is a one-way communication, if client wants to communicate with server, this IP destination address will be the server's address. So where this message has to be sent. So and the third one is protocol identifier. So as I said that this security parameter index will be carried out in both the protocols, that is ESP and AH protocol. So here this protocol identifier will say, so the security association in which protocol is used, that means either ESP or AH, in which protocol this particular security association is going to be used. So these are the three parameters to identify the security association, any security association. And security association is a one-way communication. Now, so all the security associations will be maintained in a database. So all the security associations will be maintained in the database, right? So there are different parameters associated with this security association. For every security association, there are different parameters. So these three are the parameters to identify the security association. And now we are going to see the parameters which are associated with the security association. So these parameters will be maintained in this security parameter database. So all the security associations will be maintained in security association database. We can call it as SAD. Security association database. Right? So now we are going to see the parameters which are associated with all the security associations which are in this security association database. The first one is, as we know, the SPI, that is security parameter index, the unique identification of that particular security association. Next, the sequence number counter. So as we know, the usage of sequence number, right? So based upon the bandwidth in the network, the message will be divided into different packets. So each packet will be given one unique number and it will be transmitted to the receiver. So that again, at the receiver side, they will collect all the packets and according to the number, they will arrange the data. So that is the use of this sequence number. So in order to send the packets, different packets, we will just increment this sequence number. So for that purpose, we will use this sequence number counter. That means messages, transmitting the messages. Next, sequence number overflow. So as the name itself indicates, the sequence number overflow means it specifies where to stop the messages. So up to when we have to send the message and where we have to stop the messaging. So that's we call it a sequence number overflow. That means we will give some threshold. If the sequence number reaches that particular threshold, we can activate this particular parameter, that is sequence number overflow, such that we can say that the messages should be stopped sending to the opponent or receiver. Sequence number overflow. Next, anti-replay window. So the name itself indicates, so this anti-replay window parameter is used to avoid the duplicates of packets, receiving the duplicates of packets, right? So we will have one window, right? So these are all the numbers of packets to be received. If one packet is received, just we will put a mark on this particular packet number. And if another packet has been received, we will put a tick mark on that particular packet number, right? Sequence number. So first, after receiving the packet, the number will be compared with this window. So if it is already marked, that implies that the packet has already received by the receiver. So that is a duplicate packet. So in order to avoid the duplicate of packets, we will use this anti-replay window. AH information. So here AH is an authentication header. So here in this AH information, we will get all the signature algorithms or the authentication algorithms or the integrity algorithms. So whatever the algorithms we are using for achieving the both the authentication and integrity, we can have all those information in this particular parameter, AH information. Similarly, the next one is ESP information. ESP information. So that means encapsulation security payload. So this here we will have all the cryptographic algorithms, the encryption algorithms, either symmetric or asymmetric, everything will be in this ESP information. The lifetime of security association. So every security association will be having some particular lifetime. So if the lifetime expires, then we have to regenerate the security association or re-establish this security association. So when we have to use a new security association will be in this parameter, lifetime of SCA, security association. IPsec protocol mode. So here either AH or ESP, that means authentication header or encapsulating security payload, has been implemented in two different modes. That is, one is transport mode tunnel mode. So this protocols, AH and ESP protocols, can be implemented in two modes, that is a transport mode or tunnel mode. So this parameter specifies in which mode the particular AH or ESP has been implemented. So these are all the security I mean the parameters associated with the security association. So this will be maintained in the database, security association parameters, I mean security association database. Now hope you understood this one. Then we will move on to the architecture protocols, different protocols. Here, so we have seen two protocols in the architecture. One is encapsulating security payload. Another one is authentication header protocol. So ESP protocol and AH protocol. And this will be implemented in two cases. One is ESP with optional authentication. And ESP with authentication. So in two ways this ESP can be implemented, with optional authentication or with authentication. That means in the first case we will get both the, we can achieve both the confidentiality and authentication. In the second case only the confidentiality will be achieved but not the authentication. And this authentication header, this can be implemented in only one way, that is by achieving the authentication along with the integrity. Authentication along with integrity. Right? So we have to see all these three cases. One is ESP with optional authentication, VSP, ESP with authentication, and authentication along with the integrity. So this can be shown by using this simple IP protocol, I mean IP header format. So we will see the IP header formats for both the version 4 and version 6. So which fields are authenticated and which fields are encrypted. So before going to that, first let us see the packet format of ESP. The packet format of ESP, that means encapsulate. Let us see the authentication header protocol. The packet format. The length is 32 bits. The length of the authentication header is 32 bits. Next header, the first field is next header. Payload length. Reserve. So the length is 0 to 31. So there are three fields here. First one is the next header, the payload length, and the reserve. Next one is security parameter index. We can call it as SPI. The next one is sequence number. The next one is authentication data. We can call it as integrity checksum. So this is both the with this field we can achieve both the authentication as well as the integrity, right? So next header is the next payload. Now payload length, here the payload is the actual data, right? So payload length means the data length of that particular data, and some bits will be in a reserved, so 0 to 8 and 8 to 16, right? So some bits will be for the reserved for some future extensions for future purpose. And the next one is security parameter index to identify the security association, SA. Next one is sequence number for particular packet number, and then the authentication data. So here the authentication data means after applying, so we have seen a different authentication algorithms. So that is a HMAC algorithm or secure hash algorithm or MD5 algorithm. So whatever it may be, the authentication algorithm, the result of that particular authentication algorithm, that is, we call it as a message digest or a hash code. So that particular hash code or message digest, we call it as an authentication data. So in order to achieve this authentication, we have to include this authentication data. So simple concept. So in this authentication, how to achieve this authentication, we have seen in the previous sessions, we are considering some plaintext message, applying some hash functions or the some message authentication functions. So we'll generate some fixed length value, which is called some hash code or a message digest. And we are appending that particular message digest to the plaintext message, and we are sending it to the receiver. So at the receiver side, again, the receiver will apply the same functions on the plaintext message, and again the hash code or message digest will be generated. And now the generated hash code or message digest will be compared with the appended hash code or message digest. So if the both the appended message digest or hash code and the generated hash code are not matched, that implies there might be some modification during the transmission. That means it fails the authentication as well as the integrity, right? So here the authentication data means the result of that particular authentication algorithm. So that's why we can call it as integrity checksum, right? So this is the simple packet format for this authentication header. So now let us look on IP header formats for this authentication header. IP packet format for both the two versions, let us see the two versions of IP packets, that is version 4 and version 6. So before applying this authentication header, what is the IP packet format, I mean IP header format, so for version 4 and version 6, let us see that. Original IP header. Okay. The original IP header, the TCP, and the data. So this is the IP version 4. IP version 4. Now, what about the IP version 6? So there will be some extension headers included with this IP version 4, we get the IP version 6. So now IP version 6, similar original IP header some extension headers TCP and the data. So these are the IP header formats before implementing this authentication header. Now let us look the header formats after implementing the authentication header, right, for both the version 4 and version 6. Original IP header, authentication header, TCP, and data. So this is the IP version 4. Now, what about the version 6? Original IP header. Extension headers. Authentication header included TCP and data. This is the header format for IP version 6. So after implementing, so we have to include this authentication data after the TCP and data. We have to include this authentication header field. Right, so in this version 6, this one. Now, as we have discussed in the parameter, one of the parameter of security association, that is a protocol, IPsec protocol mode. That is, these IPsec protocols will be implemented in two modes, that is transport and tunnel mode. And this is called a transport mode. Normally, just one, the data and the TCP protocol, and including the authentication header. After including the authentication header, we will apply the, or we will append the original IP header, and then this packet will be sent to the receiver. This is normal transmission. So this is called transport mode. So there is one more mode, that is another mode of implementation, that is a tunnel mode. Now, what is a tunnel mode? Tunnel mode means, so considering all these as a data, this inner packet, so everything is considered as a inner packet, and we will this considered as a data, and again we will include one more authentication header, and again we will append the new IP header, and then send to the receiver. So this complete packet will be considered as a inner IP packet. So simply we can call it as a box inbox. So this complete packet will be considered as an inner packet, and a new IP header will be included and will be sent to the receiver. That we call it as a tunnel mode. Right? Now let us see the header formats for tunnel mode. So this is a normal header format for version 4. Now this will be considered as an inner packet. Now include the AH here and include the new IP header. So this is the IP version 4 in tunnel mode. So this complete we consider as an inner packet. And we are applying the authentication data for complete inner packet. That means we are providing the authentication for complete inner packet and appending this authentication header field, and then we are appending the new IP header, and it will be transmitted to the receiver. Now coming to the version 6, that is also similar. The new IP header. The new IP header. Extension headers, the AH, and similar original IP header, and everything is same. Extension headers, the TCP, and the data. So this is the header format for IP version 6 in tunnel mode. So both the AH, protocol and ESP protocol will be implemented in both the two modes, either transport mode or tunnel mode. So here also, this is the inner packet, right? So this is the inner packet. For this inner packet, the authentication is provided and it will be appended to the inner packet, and then extension headers and new IP header will be included, and then it will be sent to the receiver. So hope you understood this authentication header. So the very simple concept. So we'll stop here. So in today's session we have seen the IP security architecture, and then we have seen the AH protocol. So in the next session we will see the one more protocol, that is ESP protocol, how to implement this ESP protocol, and followed by the key management. So hope you understood this concept, and if you are having any doubts regarding this information security, feel free to post your doubts in the comment section, so that I will definitely clarify all your doubts. And if you really understood my videos, like my videos, share my videos with your friends, and subscribe to our channel. Thanks for listening. Thank you very much.